This is Nightly Fix.
Nightly Fix.
On News Talk 93
FM. It's a fix. Bono. Welcome back to Nightly Fix News at Night Your FM. It's your boy now here at RDJ Burns. Videographer Brian. Shout out Vince. KTI. Damn. Shout out wherever I'm there right now. You see me? But. Channel star over for that. You see me? We have a guest right now. We just have to say one blood. Legend. No, we are tag living legend. Junior Reid, you hear that? Authentic.
Yeah.
I know, damn, I'm kind of there. A real deal. Really. Junior Reid, now building. Bless up.
Bless up.
Yeah. Living legend.
New album. You know, big thing.
Yeah. Talk to me more about it. You've been teased. You know what I mean? Only 5 years been here and say I make this album. Yeah, so finally I drop. What was the process like?
That's just, you know, a good journey because, you know, we enjoy the whole process, you know. Mm. Some hard work, hard dedication every night. We just dedicate the time to the music as long as, you know, we have the time away from performing live over here. So we put in a lot of time in this one. And, you know, so far we're getting a good feedback, you know, so far from the few songs that really out there, like Love Your Back, Same Boat, Never Let You Go. You know, yeah, Love Your Back, Same Boat, Never Let You Go, and Dancehall City.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, them, you kind of sing them four songs alone for the album and it's a show, same.
Yeah.
As the best art, you know.
So why it takes so long?
Yeah, because like it supposed to drop like 2009, like 2009 year, like it didn't work on this and you know.
Yeah, but we kind of so busy, you know, the studio work, you know, with overseas artists, local artists and so.
Them rappers, like, pictures.
So I do a lot of collaboration and I go and spread my name in the hip hop.
Yeah, era. Because they love you, because that's why you kind of resurge, like a resurgence, like in 2009 when? Was it? During this, the 2009, I think it was Mims and the Game. Like, it was just a resurgence.
Yeah,
people who never, young people.
Yeah.
Yeah, young people like me who's like, one blood, whatever, get a Jamaican you're from. And then, you know, you like, you dig it up and say, oh, 1978, it might come a long time, you know? So it's like, young people get to know, you know, and
kind of.
Yeah,
them things I just come.
Yeah.
go do the maths. And I say, wait, the money. Them all go and go tell them mother father. So I know this artist named Julian. I said, no, we long know Julian.
Been there, done that, yeah.
So we got people that say, yo, me know girl, who Julian Reid,
what?
Yeah.
So how's that collaboration though? Like how them Lil Wayne and say do a remix with Alicia Keys, like how these international people get in touch with
you?
They
must reach out to me.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, we just feel good for most of them find the time to reach out to me.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, me see me them is a fan.
Yeah, that's like all I'm about to say. They're like true fans.
Yeah, me's a fan of them see me. Some of us feel good, I'm just make it possible, you know. Because we all have to sing the same song, just one music. Well, you understand me, so out of hip hop music, you know, out of reggae music or hip hop music. So when hip hop requests Junior Reid, you know, I have to make myself available because it's a family affair, you know.
Yeah.
Reggae is a father and mother for the whole hip hop thing, so
this is true.
We have something, you know, in common, you know.
Yeah.
So, we want to talk about One Blood itself, because that tune did massive.
Right.
Is it that Game did sample the tune and then reach out to you, or him reach out to you before him even did do
him
the
sample
tune
it first?
Yeah.
My producer named Reefer sample it, you know, have Game on it, then him put it, them kind of. Put it out like a mix, like you know, kind of mixtape, and so you know, and leading up to the album, and then you just take off.
And so the man,
them reach out to me, and then we just go vice over back some part, you know, and then we just release it and just take the world, you know.
And Mr. said, him have respect, you know, for even say, oh, for video shoot, because sometimes the hip hop artist sample it and put it out, shoot video, and them no pay respect to the person them sampling, but reach out there and even in a video and thing.
Yeah, man, reach out and shoot the video, and so because them know so well. Sometimes you know when they have the artist, you know the music, you know, the video, and everything, it make it even more easier for the whole production, you understand me? So we give thanks to them come in and, you know, make a video possible. And you know, that's the word. Could I even say Junior Reid face, cause enough, you know, the One Blood remix video, you know, reach far than really the original One Blood video. Although the original One Blood song reached just as far as the Game song, see me? Because that's why Game even get to know about it. You know.
And so, the amount of remix
and that song was produced by Junior Reid for JR Production for my own label, you understand me? I produced that one album, that whole album.
Yeah.
So I feel good to know that my company, JR Production, you know, doing quality work, that's company like Interscope, Universal Record, Def Jam, Capital Record, Great, you know, Cash Money, Young Money, Cash Money, all of those record companies wanna work with they wanna work with JR Production, you know. So JR Production is like a
major player.
A major, right.
You're respected in the hip hop industry.
Right.
Yeah.
True that. So, talk about the new album now, Living Legend. We are finding any of them type of collaboration upon the album somewhere?
Well, there were collaboration, you know, kind of, it's a kind of experiment of one, two, Naya Bingi, hip hop. So, it's a Bingi, you know, hip hop and reggae. You understand me? So, and that feature, Vibes Cartel and Uncle Murder.
Vibes Cartel.
That's a good look.
How you work with Vibes Cartel? Is this pre-jail or what's happening? How everybody is collaborating with Cartel?
No, this boy is long time.
Well, yes,
it's boy is long time. I'm a song with Buju Banton. You understand me? No people want to know how me get this song with Buju Banton, but them remember when Bama was it when Obama was in Jamaica, I meeting with Obama. You understand?
This is a real thing, man.
And we have the track with Bojo Banton, so it's crazy.
Yeah. So that's also on the album.
It's on the album. Mm-hmm.
Okay, yes. But you're saying that you know you did a song.
And I have a track with Cesar Kalonji on the album as well.
And you say because it's mostly reggae, you describe it as reggae.
It's mostly reggae, like one original foundation, back to basic.
Yeah.
One drop, live acoustic.
Yeah, but then you have one song that's pop. Like it's a pop commercial feel.
Well, we have the Love You Back.
Yeah.
You know, make it kind of reggae pop.
So why you choose to do one? Like, why you never just make it strictly reggae? You think that, you know, for it to be more commercially successful in the markets that buy music?
No, why would we do it like that so that one will quickly catch the radar people them ears?
Okay.
And it would make way for the whole album.
So we just use
a more commercial song to open doors for the rest of hardcore reggae. Yeah. Same, you know?
Mm-hmm. So it was made as a radio record?
Well, radio friendly. And street friendly, club friendly, all friendly.
Mm-hmm.
Just like One Blood, you know? Just friendly.
Because
everybody want to love somebody and want somebody to love them back.
True.
That's true.
Ariane can attest.
I can attest.
I would have asked if your son influenced because I hear him do all type of reggae infused, pop infused type music, you know? So, Young JR, the musical lineage.
You know, Young JR inspire me, and I inspire them. You know, and you know, other people inspire him, but you know, the youths have inspired me. You understand me? Juju Blood, Young JR, Wadda Blood, Andrew Blood, and other artists out there to know for the youth. You know, I inspire them, and them inspire me. You understand me?
But how? Cause that's profound, though. Cause you almost. I guess more established artists would never say a young act inspired him.
But because a man finna say, you know, say what them do?
Yeah, like what is it that, you know, that stands out make you say, well, them inspire?
Inspire me. Well, all right. You see, in order to keep yourself relevant, that's how I really have young fans, you know, from the age of 2-3, because I have 2-year-old fans. And so you have to get inspiration from the youths. Because them say a child shall lead the way, you understand me? You can't go around the youths are the future. So if you want to be a part of the future, you have to work with the youths.
That is true.
You understand me? That's why, you know, the youths inspire me, because you have to know where the youths want, and you know what to give them. So me know the youth them want, so I just give the youth them want. We just get the youth them with them all.
So you don't like reject, like, you know, everyone's like, oh, reggae this, reggae that, dancehall this, dancehall that. Like, you reject new dancehall, new school dancehall in any way, shape or form?
Well, all right. No, I mean, all right. Just a message, you know. You see, from the message positive, you know, I'm with it. But if it's a negative message, we are leading youth in the or disrespect the sister them. You know, really, any song when me love, me, you know, it have to be a song when me can go play it to my grandmother and say, listen to this grandma, she can listen to it and all her vibes. And any song when me sing, I suppose can go play it for my grandmother and she listen to all her vibes.
Yeah.
You understand me? Even if it's a hip-hop song and the rapper them, I say, yo, this tata not much more. When you listen to my part, you can't be my part now, go cross my line.
You ain't have a cringe, I'm like, ah.
Yeah, so when they say now, go cross my line, like, me now, go say something out of the way, come out of my zone.
True that.
You understand me, so, you know, yeah, man.
Okay.
Junior, how much kids have? God, it won't look like you compete with Bob, man.
I think he's past Bob, man.
You know, you see the amount of youth me have, you see all youth in the world are my youth, you know. You understand, that's why I said JR production. Yeah, man, because at the end of the day, you know, for me, I have youth, and you love your youth, you have to love others, you have like other youth, you know, and respect. And you understand me? So, all youth are my youth, but originally, you know, we come out, you know, my.
Your offspring, your blood.
No, sir.
No pun intended.
We have 18 youth.
And I couldn't believe it when he said it. I was like, huh?
At the same time.
That I am blood strong. You know, one blood.
The whole of them, you know, I'm proud of the whole of them.
Yeah.
And then the whole of them, I do something positive. Be a big people, them. And at the end of the day, you know, I just love to know, say, my youth, them come. Them don't, you know, me as a father, we stick by my youth, them, and teach them the right from the wrong. And let people know my youth, them. You understand? It's not like some artists. You see them every day, but you never see them youth.
Yeah.
And you see them, I show you, go ahead, and I say, me, I call on one of my son, but I am real son.
Shots
when
fire.
Me say, me, I call on my son, me, I tell about my real son.
Yeah.
Big future. Me?
So, and you have someone, they don't want nobody know them sons, and they say, my artist, them just hide them, you, me not, if you know me, and you respect my work, you have to know my son, then that means you can give them the same respect to, and show them, how great them old man is, that them could I even want to be like them old man.
Yeah.
You understand me? So me have to be a figure for my youth, them and just know, say, yeah, you know, be there with them. You understand
me? See all promote their music to your various page. Good to see.
Yeah, man,
so you just say you have a hands-on approach, I just say, I just step back, make them do them thing.
You influence them coming into music, like you're aggressive, like a hubba.
No, them just come in, naturally.
Yeah.
And just I do them thing, I'm gonna support them in everything with them do. You understand me? And try to teach them, we can teach them.
Yeah.
And sometimes they have them own way, I feel slow, make a man just do him thing.
Yeah.
And then if later on, him see where you did say it right, and him come forward around, and so, you know, but if you allow them to be creative and do him, I just still, and you still teach him your way, still. And for them accept it, you just know, so well, that's why you know, force nothing from the youth.
Is it hard working with your sons? I know they're producers, you know?
No, man, it's a
you
job.
You want something, them want something.
No, man, we can work it. We just work on, you know, we have a little dispute about something, but we gradually work it out. At the end of the day, just that, you know, we all want the best, and it's with us, you know, just the truth we are dealing with, and the right. So from me right or them right.
So what kind of dispute would I have? Like, is it like.
Like both a rhythm or like both a mixer or something. Because sometimes you have to tell a youth, say, well, maybe I hear a mix and I like the mix and you don't like the mix. But at the same time, you know, and next video this track around and say, yeah, the mix, I like the mix. And sometimes you as a producer don't like a mix and that's a mix for it. You don't like a song and the song that will run where you don't know. You're not singing for yourself.
Yeah.
You're singing for the people. Them. Yeah. So once you see the people them take on to it, just give it to them. You understand me?
So we talk about your various work done with rappers over the years. The number one rapper right now, arguably Drake. You've been rumored to be working with him. Or any news about that collaboration, anything I go on or so.
With
a tune with Drake.
Oh, tune with Drake?
Yeah.
Yeah, well,
I love the Jamaican culture.
Yeah, man. Well, right now, we are linked still on, you know. You understand me? On our vibes still, so. You know, and you know, sometimes you don't really want to let out everything still. You have to leave
it. He's a guardian. He's like, wait, I think, maybe.
Yeah, but, yeah, man, I link and, you know, can look out.
for a top 10 hit.
Yeah, look up. Mm.
Billboard top hits.
But I ask you, what's it like partnering with them rappers? Yeah? Because you're a Rasta and for them lifestyle kind of different and things.
Oh. Yeah, what them do like them?
Yeah, them turn around. How you partner with them?
Well, they must love partner with I and Jamaica, you know, because they look up to me. You understand? Because you know, say, at the end of the day, the whole world are Rasta, you know. So we have some of them gravitate to them, just love the flex and the whole thing.
Mm.
And we feel good around, we feel good around them.
Mm.
And that's why we can work good together, make hits together. You understand me? Me and a man aspire, if you you drink whatever you drink, me I drink whatever me I drink. And sometimes you drink what you drink, and if me drink what you drink, me I drink together. I also have vibes, got one blood, you understand me?
Mm.
When I restrict nobody, you know, the freedom of how them want to move towards building our vibes for doing them work.
And you don't feel restricted around them? You know?
I'm not feel restricted.
Okay. Any plans to, slow down anytime soon after ask?
Slow down?
Yeah, what the plans after
this
album?
You have a next album?
What the plans after?
All right, the plans after this album, we'll go out there and tour and promote the album for the people them. I know so Junior Reid come with album like some man every 3 months or every 6 months we come with album.
Cause Junior Reid come in like a next Nate Dogg and the hook. Like people just go for Junior Reid. Right. Like even the go to prayer for the hook.
Yeah.
Yeah man, you have time and we just easy on the school and also well right now I'm a grandchildren time and we just know so well. You know, also but right now we're up on a mission and you know we have something for get the world yet, I'm gonna get the world yet. So get the world can just know something here. Expect something great from Junior Reid and the One Blood family, Young JR, Juju Blood, Andrew Reid, Wadda Blood, whole One Blood family. You understand me? I have a next son up overseas named Madula, them Jamaican not see Madula yet.
Mm.
No hear shanty yet, eh?
I feel like the son, that child didn't really born, but he doesn't speak it into existence.
But right now, you're going to come at the album launch, and then you're going to see Madula. You understand me? And, you know, yeah, man, anything, you can expect anything at this album launch. And, you know, because there's so much artists featuring the album.
Junior.
You know, you have Junior Mali, you have Sizzla Kalanji, you have Buju Bantan, you have Cartel. Don't surprise if you see Cartel come out.
Everyone's gonna want to come to the album.
I tell you, a Junior Reid sound like if you have pull them strings.
You know, Juju Blood. You know, the whole One Blood family, you understand me?
Tell them what people with this launch are going. The 25th, well, right?
This launch going to take place at Lindsay Crescent, half Dunrobin Avenue, on the 25th of August. And it's going to be a live performance by Junior Reid performing song from the album.
And the event itself will be streamed live?
It will be streaming live. And so, and I'll be, you know, artists that feature on the album will be doing song together as well.
Mm.
You know, me and my son, Young JR, Juju Blood, you know. And we're going to have special guests like Bongo Herman, enough surprise guests as well. You understand me? No surprise if Sizzla pass because Sizzla is on the album. And you understand me? And showtime from 8 until 12. It's an early thing.
The website where they can go and watch it to stream when it's streaming?
You can check it out on juniorreid.com.
Juniorreid.com. Yeah. Okay.
All right, people. Living Legend. In stores, online, the 25th August. Go cop it. Junior Reid, Living Legend. Nightly Fix.
And the new single, Love Your Back, and the video out.
Mm.
Crazy. Just check out the video as well.
All right. People, Living Legend, Junior Reid.
But you know it's Dam Dam, also known as Random Guy. You don't know representing for the 90 Things, Addictive the Entertaining Media. I'm going to tell you this right about now. I just want to know subscribe to us on YouTube. Don't forget that someday. People, also like us on Facebook. All right, because you know Facebook. Follow us on Twitter, because we're out in a beta. Talk with Spitter. And also, don't forget the Instagram. You got to follow us on Instagram, because you know the Instagram is where the thing. Warning. See? Some sooner, morning.